Hey everybody, my name is John from Community Life Church, and this is Meals Ready to Eat from the Bible. We would really appreciate a like and subscribe. Hello, today's episode is The Thorns and Weeds Around Us Can Block Out the Light of the Gospel If We Listen to Them. Jesus speaks words we can live by. The thorns of this world do not. They don't speak anything that brings life or brings hope or brings help even. Let's take a look at today's scripture. Get that up on the screen for us. Again, this is Mark 4, and we're going to be reading verses 3 through 9. Let me just check, see if it's up there. Okay, let's read through this together and see what the Word of God has to say for us today. Listen to this. Behold, the sower went out to sow. As he was sowing, some seed fell beside the road, and the birds came and ate it up. Other seed fell on the rocky ground where it did not have much soil, and immediately it sprang up because it had no depth of soil. And after the sun had risen, it was scorched, and because it had no root, it withered away. Other seed fell among the thorns, and the thorns came up and choked it, and it yielded no crop. Other seeds fell into good soil, and they grew up and increased, they yielded a crop and produced 30, 60, and 100-fold. And he was saying, he who has ears to hear, let him hear. Later on in the story, it says this in verse 13, and he said to them, do you not understand this parable? How will you understand these parables? The sower sows the word. That's Mark 4, 13 and 14. So he goes on to explain the story so that his followers, that's us, that's you and me, can know what he is saying. So the third type, we've been looking at this parable all along here. This is the third type, or the third place where the seed falls, and it's among the thorns and weeds and other noxious plants. Other seed fell among thorns, and the thorns grew up and choked it, and it yielded no grain, it says in 4:7 of Mark. These seeds and weeds and thorns and these noxious plants grow taller than the grain-bearing plants, that's the good word, and block out the sun so that the seed cannot grow and bear fruit. The seeds grow taller, and the seeds are planted in the rocky ground along the roadside, but they will never reach maturity. In other words, they do get to grow a little bit, but because the weeds and noxious plants and all the stuff around them grow bigger still, they cannot grow and produce fruit. Here's what Jesus says about this, about them. And the others are the ones sown among thorns. They are those who hear the word, they hear it, but the cares of this world and deceitfulness of riches and desires for other things enter in and choke the word, and it proves unfruitful. So they get to grow a little bit, they get to hear a little bit, but they're not really paying attention. It's not going deep inside of them. They're not really listening, these seeds. So Jesus is putting emphasis on the choices made by the seed sown in the thorns. Their destiny is not determined by the thorns that they were sown in, but by the desires for other things. These weeds that grow up are desires for other things that block out the light of the gospel. Clearly, what we desire can determine how we act, what we do, how we live. If we desire God, we're going to act in a way to satisfy that desire. If we desire something else, our actions and lives will reflect such. Excuse me. We see this explanation that it is not where we are sown by the seed in the thorns. Their destiny is not determined by this, but by how they react to it, what their desires are. So it is our reaction to where we are sown that determines how we're going to live. Every person has issues and challenges in their life, whether we turn to God or not, whether we live by faith or not. It is a choice given to us, and we must respond to that choice. You have no choice but to respond to the choice, so to speak. So we have a choice in this. You know, some of us may think, you know, I thought, you know, everything is already determined, or we don't get a choice, or this, I was born this way, or something like that. But yes, we do have a choice. And this is what Jesus means when he says in Mark 4:9, and he was saying, he who has ears to hear, let him hear. We have to learn to listen. We have to listen. This is a command. It means you had better listen. We get to choose what we listen to. We get to choose what we hear that goes deep down in our heart and our soul. And we get to choose how to act as a result of it. So it is important that we are overshadowed by the world, by the thorns that grow up around us and try to block out the light of God, that we learn to look at God and we learn to listen to His word and not the words of the weeds in this world. Because those words that come from these weeds that block out the light of the gospel do not have life. Do not have hope, do not have anything for us. What we choose to listen to is important. It controls what we do. So pay attention to Jesus, listen to Him carefully, and let His words be the words we live by. Thanks for watching. You can join us Sunday morning, 10:30 at 20 West Main Street, Catskill, New York. Can't make it? You can stream our services live on YouTube or Facebook, which you can find on our web at clchurch.cc. That's clchurch.cc. Don't forget to follow us throughout the week for devotions and times of sharing from leaders and staff. Leave a comment, leave a like, whatever you want. And thanks once again.